गुड मॉर्निंग लिसनर्स, वंस अगेन वी आर हेयर विद वन मोर टॉपिक दैट इज लिपिड्स हेयर इन इन दिस टॉपिक वी डील विद द क्लासिफिकेशन पार्ट इन फॉरमोस्ट प्रैक्टिस क्लासिफिकेशन इन डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट मींस सैचुरेटेड अनसैचुरेटेड ऑयल्स फैट्स ट्रांस सिस कॉन्जुगेटेड लिनोलिक एसिड एंड मेनी मोर बिसाइड दिस द बेनिफिट एंड हार्म अफेक्ट रिगार्डिंग द कंजप्शन ऑफ लिपिड और ऑयल्स एंड फैट विल बी देयर. Good morning students, today we are here once again regarding fat discussion, fats in foods, its classification, application aspects and chemistry aspect wherein we deal with saturated, unsaturated, phospholipid, cholesterol part and various application part of fats in foods. So what is fat? Fat as a basic source, its role like it is a nutrient that provides us 9 calorie per gram of fat. It is a source of energy that add taste and texture to the food, makes us feel full longer, protect heart and other vital organs. It will helps to absorb various fat soluble vitamins, that is vitamin A, D, E and K. Moreover, in concern to food, if fatty chapati is there, fat based chapati is there, fried stuff is there, that having long shelf life means it extends the keeping quality of the food. It also helps some of the traditional foods like we have samosas, chapatis and butter naan. These have butter in them, means fat source in them, that adds along with texture to food. Okay, as per the basic structure of fat, it having a long hydrocarbon chain that extended from short chain fatty acid means 2, 4, 6 or 8 to the 20, 24, 26, whatever the range. One of the end of this fatty acid structure is carboxylic acid and another one is the other methyl group end. Okay. Organic and inorganic. Let's sum up with these basic chemistry about the organic and inorganic. The organic molecules are the group of molecules that contains carbon in them or whose molecules having CH or CC bond in them. Wherever, in case of inorganic compounds that are without carbon atom or originate from non-living matter. These are available in organic molecules are residing in living system. But on the other hand, the inorganic molecules are considered to be inorganic and present in or non-living portion. These are no doubt some compounds containing carbon compounds, but they are not been placed onto the organic side, like CO, carbon monoxide, CO2, carbon dioxide and cyanide molecules. Similarly, two basic terms are also there where we get confused. So first of all, sum up about all those stuffs like polar compounds. Polar compounds are undergo ionic bonding due to difference in their charges. For example, water having H positive and OH negative molecules. So they are positively and negatively charged molecules. Non-polar compounds on the other hand undergo covalent bonding due to sharing of electrons. For example, CH4, where four hydrogen molecules get involved onto the valence shell of carbon and the stability aspect arises. Less electronegativity difference lead to less dipole moment among non-polar molecules. As per the basic chemistry, you can say reaction that undergone by fat wherein by the way of presentation of this structure and the reaction group, we can get a little bit more about the fats wherein triglyceride or you can say fats or oil, these molecules are this is the monoglyceride, diglyceride and triglyceride. These are esters of fatty acid like R, C, double bond O, O, R dash, that is the ester group. So these esterified group on reaction with sodium hydroxide, that is base alkali, you can say in the local name by caustic soda, whenever they get react, it will lead to the rise of glycerol molecule from this one position. It get cut and the H molecule get joined here, hence glycerol will arise. And on the second hand side, R, C, double bond, O, O, and the three sodium molecules get attached to this. So it will form, or this is the basic structure of soap. So you, or in other words, you can say it, sodium salts of fatty acids. Triglycerides are the type of fat found in blood. When you eat, body converts any calories it doesn't need to use right away into triglycerides. The triglycerides are stored in fat cells. Later, enzyme releases them for energy production when there is scarcity of food. Now, the classification part, lipids. Fats and oils are broadly categorized under the lipid part, where lipids further categorized down to fats and oils. Fats are the solid proportion that is solidified at room temperature, but oils are the liquid proportion that are liquids at room temperature. Lipids are the heterogeneous group of organic compounds that are soluble in non-polar organic solvents. I already disclosed you what are the organic and inorganic part, what are the polar and non-polar compounds. So, lipids are the heterogeneous group of organic compounds soluble in non-polar organic solvent, for example, ether, chloroform, hexane, benzene, acetone, petroleum ether, and insoluble in water, which includes cooking oil, butter, ghee, waxes, and cholesterol. They worked on to the principle of like dissolve like, means polar solvents are best to dissolve polar reactants among them, such as ionic. Non-polar solvents are best to dissolve non-polar reactants among them, such as hydrocarbons. Visible fat, one more classification is there, that is visible and hidden fat. As we know, butter is itself wholesome fat portion. Cooking oil is fat, vanaspati, as we can see it through naked eyes. So visible fat is butter, cooking oil and vanaspati. But in case of some of the cereals, grains, seeds, caryopsis, fats are also there to nourish the initiated hypocotyl and epicotyl, or you can say plumule and radical activation. In that case, the emerging root and shoot get initiated onto the incubation time, temperature and condition, but they'll get their nourishment through fat portion. As we can see it through naked eyes, the caryopsis or wheat kernel, maize kernel cannot be observed through touch or taste. Fat is there in them, but they having around 2-4% of fat among them. So that is one of the classification among hidden fat. So most of the cereals having hidden fat in them, pulses, skim milk is there, but even that it contains not more than 0.5. Next classification is simple lipids, compound lipids and derived lipids. As the name suggests, these are the esters of fatty acids with various alcohols. Simple lipids furtherly classified into neutral fats and waxes. Simple lipids are esters of fatty acid with various alcohol, but whenever coming to the neutral or true fats, these are the esters of fatty acid with specifically glycerol part only. But when comes to the waxes, these are the esters of fatty acid with various alcohol but other than glycerol. So neutral and true fat further categorized into three parts, mono, di and triglyceride. Monoglyceride contains single fatty acid, di two fatty acids, triglyceride three fatty acids. Compound or conjugated lipids, these are the esters of fatty acids with alcohol but contain some other substances also. Means along with fat or fatty acids, some non-fat proportion is also attached. That's why we get it through the naming nomenclature, means compound or conjugated lipids. For example, phospholipids means in along with lipid portion, fatty portion, phosphate parts is there. Next is glycolipids. In along with lipid proportion, some of the sugar part is also attached. In case of lipoprotein, means in adjacent to the lipid portion, some non-lipid or you can say protein part is also attached. Last classification is derived lipid. In case of derived lipid, it can be observed through its nomenclature. These are the esters of fatty acids, or these are formed after hydrolysis of above lipid. For example, fatty acids, glycerol, steroids. One more thing is there, that these are derived lipids that even get derived onto the digestion part. Classification. One more classification is existing in case of fats, that is unsaturated and saturated fats. Unsaturated fatty acids or unsaturated fats is the classification that contains double bonds in them. We can observe this thing from here. दिस इज द कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड एंड दिस वन इज द मिथाइल एंड एंड दिस इज द लॉन्ग हाइड्रोकार्बन चेन. इट इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ लिनोलिक एसिड. वी कैन गो इट अहेड इन द फर्दर स्लाइड्स. हेयर डबल बॉन्ड्स आर अवेलेबल. सो दीज अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ दीज डबल बॉन्ड्स वी कैन से दीज आर द अनसेचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड. अनसेचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स क्लासिफाइड इन वेरियस क्लासेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल मोनो एंड पोली अनसेचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स. मोनो अनसेचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड जनरली प्रोनाउंस एज म्यूफा हैविंग ओनली सिंगल डबल बॉन्ड इन इट्स स्ट्रक्चर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल ओलिक एसिड. ओलिक एसिड इज अवेलेबल इन ऑलिव एंड कैनोला ऑयल. Similarly, polyunsaturated fatty acids pronounced through the name PUFA, for example linoleic acid, fish oil that having two or more than two double bonds in them. Another classification is saturated fats that is without any double bonds in their structure. These are short chain fatty acids. For example, these are butyric acid like C4 carbon compounds that is available in milk fat, lauric acid C12 carbon compounds contained in coconut oil and breast milk, myristic acid C14 carbon compound available in cow's milk and other dairy products. Similarly, palmitic and stearic acid. These are the fat structures wherein no one double bond exists in them. Fats of one more classification is there. That is fats of plant's origin are more on unsaturated side. For example, sesame seed oil means unsaturated proportion or fats we can avail from the plant sources only maximally. But in case of saturated fats, the maximally non-veg proportion or muscular meat proportion is rich in saturated fat proportion. This is one of the means idea regarding the availability of carbon hydrocarbon chain and their common and systemic name. For example, these are the saturated fatty acids. These, for example, butyric, that is of four carbon compound, two carbon, third and this one. So it's known by the name tetranoic acid. Palmitic acid is 16 carbon compound, 14 carbon, 15, 16. It's known by the name hexadecanoic acid. Stearic acid, this is one of the third saturated fatty acids having 18 carbon in them, 16, 17 and lastly 18. Octadecanoic acid, lastly arachidic, it is also one of the saturated fatty acids having 20 carbon compound, 18, 19 and 20. These all are saturated fatty acids that don't have double bond in them. But in case of unsaturated fatty acids, oleic acid having 18 carbon compound with one double bond available in olive oil. Linoleic 18 carbon with two double bond. Students, you have to grasp the things in a sequence order as listed here. Oleic, linoleic, linolenic 18:1, 18:2, 18:3. Arachidonic 20:4. Next is EPA and DHA, that is eicosapentaenoic acid, docosahexaenoic acid, that having 20 carbon with 5, 22 carbon with 6 double bond, mostly available through marine sources. And as per the rise in the bond, double bond structures in the hydrocarbon chain, we are on to the concluding side. As the number of double bond rises, the fat proportion or the lipid is the best suited to the human consumption. Hence, categorized onto the MUFA, unsaturated to unsaturated, unsaturated from MUFA to PUFA side and even PUFA omega sides. So, saturated, unsaturated, we differentiated once here. Saturated, I already told you, these are singly bonded, fully valent carbon with hydrogen. These are doubly bonded hydrocarbon chain. Occurs in mostly animal fats. Occurs in mostly plant fats. Saturated, solids at ordinary temperature. So this is known by the name fats. Unsaturated, liquid at ordinary temperature, thus they are known by the name oils. These having high melting point, then unsaturated fats. These having low melting point, then saturated fats. Lastly, saturated fats are less abundant in livings, but unsaturated fats are more abundant in living beings. Cis and trans fats. This is the last classification, second last classification after this omega classification is there. In this, as we already know in the lower classes about cis and trans configuration, Firstly, what is cis configuration? Any of the carbon chain having the same molecular pattern onto the same type of bonds or the functional group available onto the same side, then it is categorized under cis classification. But in case of trans, the position of functional group or the remaining molecule attached to the central carbon atom get shifted onto the opposite side. This shifting in case of fats altogether varied the properties of fat. Cis and trans, that is hydrogenated, turn vegetable oil into solids, allow for longer shelf life, increases LDL cholesterol level. Hydrogenation, if double bonded molecule is there and if that double bonded molecule get hydrogenated, that turns into the means that is unsaturated, but whenever it get shifted to singly bonded onto the attachment through hydrogen atom, then it turns liquid oils to solid fats. Hence stability aspect increases, but LDL aspect or LDL cholesterol also rises. Food sources are for these trans fatty acids are or saturated fatty acids are shortening, crackers and all baked stuffs. Some trans fats with double bond prove to be beneficial as human feed because they are carcinogenic. For example, CLA, that is conjugated linoleic acid, is one of the example or exception that is classified under trans classification, but many having better impact onto the human. So this is the mechanism of trans fat formation. Generally, trans fat formation comes on to the polar compound generation, and that will generate after getting high temperature treatment in presence of oxygen. Whenever hydrolysis means in case or in presence of water, many of monodi triglycerides will form. Here, in presence of oxygen, oxidation will occurs of fat that turns to peroxides and then hydroperoxide. These will shift it on to the aldehyde, ketone, acid, dimers and epoxides. These polar compound, whenever subjected to frying in oils, these fried oils rises the oil uptake in foods, and whenever food get uptake, they releases the water proportion or get dehydrated. So this is the trans fat formation. Whenever the high heating is there and oil uptake is there, the oil gets shifted its properties and turns trans side. On heating, high temperature processing, isomerization, cyclization and polymerization also form the trans fats. Thank you students. This is all about the classification aspect regarding the lipid portion, or you can say oils and fats in foods. Thank you.